To train and break and all that with the same practice, and how much deep and complete is the work and like this balance.
I jump, usually my leg doesn't reach between my arms. yearbook page. The tight lecture, that's the only reason. The hip flexors are tight. Stretch more on the quad, stretch more on the hip flexors.
Yeah, it's the same when I move my leg.
Yes, the same, same thing. Tight. You want to step, but they are tight, they're not letting you step.
Yeah.
Work on the quad, stretch.
Usually it's after my hand.
Yeah, yeah, same thing. You need to work on the quad. Finish? Okay, ladies, come on, come on. Come on, to the front, to the front, to the front. We have 40 minutes left, that's it. So if you want to practice, we got no more thing, come forward.
And where the right goes, so I've done the right one in red color. The right passes through the different areas and reaches here. And we call that Pingala. Can you say that?
Pingala.
Pingala. Pingala.
Pingala.
Pingala.
Pingala.
And the left is Ida.
Ida. Ida.
Can you just check which nostril is open for you just now? For me, my left is open.
Left.
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 How many of you are right? Done. Done.
Yeah.
Rest your toes, lift the chest, roll the shoulders upward, tuck your toes, lift through your hip into downward facing dog. Press the heels on the ground. Spread your fingers wide on the ground. And lift into your butt, lift into your tail, and let's focus on the 5 inhalation and expansion. Squeeze your throat as you inhale and exhale. One. Squeeze your throat as you inhale and exhale. Two. If you can, then gate and look at your navel and belly button. Three. Hold. Four. And five. Bend your knees, step or jump in front of your mat as you inhale and exhale. Pull forward.
It's good. I'm sorry.
اتشنمتي؟ حبيتي الموضوع؟
Super easy, doesn't need a lot of alignment. The only thing that you have to check is, now this is something that you will achieve over the period of time with your practice, is getting your feet exactly and perfectly aligned in together. The reason I said that, the point where you are going to start your practice should be the exact point where you are going to close your practice. So if you are practicing regularly, after a while your mat will have three spots. Where you start, where you drop your knees, or where your downward dog, where your head touches the ground, and the third one is your feet. That's how it will end up becoming. But that will happen with time. But for now, what you will do, the easiest way, or to start a beginner class, is to have a slight difference, or a slight gap in between your legs. How much gap is needed? One block. Body has more strength. The moment your hand goes forward, or it goes back, you lose strength. Feel it for yourself. So you sit, just will get into a cat pose. Align your shoulder with your wrist. And just feel the strength in your palm. Now, take one step forward. There's a very mild difference, but not the same amount of power. Take one step back. And you see you are over pushing and pressing your palm from the ground. And one that happened
wrong
was
position.
So exactly. That's why geometry of the body is so very tricky. That when you move with mindfulness and you move your body in a way. That's why wrist injuries are very, very.
Every week, 2 times. Malvis people has a great opening in this technique. Even I'm approached in this meditation by people who never meditate before. They don't know anything. Yeah? Yeah, the teachers, of course, they know this. So I'm very, very happy if you are new to this meditation. Last time you had a small experience of shaking your body, jumping, even the screaming. Now we are going to take second round of our chakra journey. This time it's going to be more powerful, more opening.